Hello guys, in this video we will look at the console commands. So we will try to create a CLI or CLI commands from the terminal. So first of all, I've just created the skeleton for a module, and this module just have the module.xml and registration file and nothing special to it. We will create a class, we will call it example or something. So we will create it inside console command, and then we call it example command. Not a folder, but we need to create a PHP file, example command, and we just create this space. So the class will extend command from Symfony. So we'll extend the Symfony command, and what we need to do is we need to do the configure method, and it just recall the parent configure, and then we add our stuff into it. So first of all, we need to set the name, this set name, and the name will be simply the namespace, and then subject, then action. So you will have this format of the name: namespace, subject, and then action. So the namespace will be training, the subject will be example, and then we just do the action as run. Now we set the description. Description will be training example, training console example. So that's it for now for configure. Now we need to implement the execute method. So execute, and the execute we will write some text on the output. So output write hello world, and that's it for the class for now. Now we need to initialize it and set it in the di xml file. So we will have di.xml file, then m2di. Now in the di we will need type. In the type we will have the command, the Magento framework console command list interface, and then we add the list into it. So we will have arguments here, and then we need commands, and these will be an array. So I type array, and then we will have an item, and the name of the item I will call it example, and this will be an object, and then I'll just copy the class here and paste it in. So this should create me the console command for training example run. So let's flush cache, cache flush config, and then we will run this command. Now we flush the cache, we will run the command php pin magento training example run. Now it gives us the hello world, but it gives us this thing because this is all in line, in one line. So if we say hello world, and then we will do another text welcome back, for example, and then run the command, we will see them all in one line. So the write will always input the text in one line. What we need to do is maybe write line will give us a new line. So every time you write a line, then it will be new line. If you just type write, then it will be just everything you write is in one line. But we need line here, ln, write ln. This will give us this text in one line and welcome back in one line. So if we run it again, we have those both in separate lines. So this is the difference between write and write ln. So these are going to be, I need to keep them as write here and probably just comment them out so you can refer to them when you look at the code in the repository. Now we have this write line, and also we have a formatted input or output. So you can have these as in red or green or whatever you want. So we have four styles for this. So to do this, we will just copy these in. I think we need just one, the hello world. If I want it as info, so we will type info, and then inside the info you type hello world, and then you will have comment, and also you will have error, and also you will have question. Now if we need it as just bare without any styling, and I'll just comment these so they don't show. Now if we run the command, you will have hello world as in just right line. These are the info, and this is the comment, and the white text but the red background is error, and black text and cyan or whatever the color is, the greenish, is as a background. So these are the different styles you can have when you output the text in your command. Now we have these, we need to know about the arguments and options. First of all, let's have a look at the arguments. To add an argument, so let's have these as commented here. This will be one line text, this will be formatted style text, here will be new line text. Now we need to know about the arguments. So first of all, let's have an argument, and we can say this add argument, you put first the argument name. So say for example I want to put the product ID, and then product ID as underscore, and then I will have the options, the mode, how do I want it, is it required or optional. So what I want to do is I will have input argument required, and what I want here is the comment, so it's a product ID. So this is the argument. Once I put an argument and I specify as required, then I will get an error if I don't specify it. So if I go and run the command, I will get an error, missing argument, because I need to add a product ID. So if I put one and then it runs fine, but there's no way of outputting or knowing what's going on in here. So what we need to do is to intercept it from here. So to display it, I need to go to the get input, get argument, and I'll call it product ID. And in the product ID, in when you get the argument, you will have product ID here, and you can have output right line product ID. So I just input it and then output it, nothing fancy here. So if I do this, then I will get the one, because I do write it out. So you have it as an input, as an argument, and then you have it as output. You can do whatever you want with the product ID. Now we have this argument, but also you can make this argument, so this by default is the argument, so you only have one argument, but also you can have it as an array, not just required, but as array. So you can do by pipe, and then input argument is array. In fact, I want it in a different line, so you will have it product IDs here, and then we'll have it as input argument array. I will also comment this. Now I will have this as an array, and I will need to intercept it as product IDs here, and then I'll call these as product IDs. So to do this, I will have one, then I will get one. If I put two, I will get one, two. So by default, when you write an array here in the right line, it will loop through the array and put the output the values. So you don't need to loop through and then put it in the right line, because the right line method will loop through it. Let me have a look. Output style, maybe this is the output, and then this right line. So if it is iterable, and then it will loop through the messages here. So this is why when you pass in the array, it will output it as a new lines, because it iterates through them. Now I have these as array. I can also have optional, so I will have this copy, and then instead of having it as required, I'll do as optional, and it's a product ID, so we will need to see product ID here. Now if I do it as optional, I don't need to run anything, so it just runs without complaining about missing arguments, because they are optional. However, if I put here the same as required and argument, we can also have as array, and then you can also have it without, because it's optional, and also you can have it with 1, 2, 3, 3 as values you pass in. Now you have these as optional, and you can have it as an array. So you can have this as just optional, we comment it, and then this optional. Now if we have this argument as optional, well, not this one, first one as optional, and then we will have this required, so we can have this as required. Maybe we need to rename these. So say for example required product ID, and here required product IDs, and here required optional, here is optional. Now if I have optional product ID and required product ID, if I put here required product ID as a product ID and then run, it will give me the value. If I put these as well here, but this time is optional, and then run it again. So this will be fine, but if I put 2, it will give me 1 and 2. So the first argument is required and second argument is optional. Now this is fine in terms of doing this. However, what happens if I put the optional first here? I'm gonna delete it in a minute, but here we just try, we put the optional first and then required first second. So we will do here the same. This will give us an error because the optional arguments cannot come before the required. So required always comes first and then the optional. So this is one of the things you need to bear in mind. The other thing is you have this required, and then you will have also this required optional IDs, and you will have this required as a single argument and this one as an array. Now if you run it, and I want this required product IDs, now if you run it here, you will get an error, because the error comes because these are going to be ambiguous. You have required and you have an array. Probably you can manipulate these and probably try to bring these first, the array first, and then the single argument second, and you try again and still having an error. This is because it will be ambiguous, as you have argument as an array and then you pass another argument, but you don't know the length of the first argument, and you might get into errors. So Symfony will fail on this, because let me have this commented so we can understand it better. Now as an array, you don't know how many arguments you passed for the array and whether the last argument belongs to the array or belongs to itself. This is why it fails. You can have either required, or you can have either an array and you don't have any argument after it or before it, because this is always going to be ambiguous when you try to run the input array, and then you will have as many arguments for the array as you want, and the last argument or the first argument, you never know how you call it, first or second. And if that's true, then the command application wouldn't know whether this argument belongs to the array or not. So that's why it fails, and you can either have an argument as an array or a single one and then another single one. And now here you can have it as an array and it doesn't exist. We have this product IDs, required product IDs. We just want this to comment, and now you will get IDW, and now you will have just an array. So this is another thing you need to bear in mind when creating a console and add arguments, and you might go into errors. Arrays cannot work together with single arguments, so you can always have either array or just single arguments one after another, so you would know which argument which. Now this is, we are done here for the arguments. Now we will need to go for the options. So let's comment all the arguments here. I think I need to bring this back to the first line. Now we will go with the optional, with the options. So you will say this add option, as in the argument you give an option name. So I will give it a, say for example, required name, and this will be option, this will be input option, and I want it as required, and then will be required name, and I need here null because we don't have a shortcut for it. Now we have the required, and then we will have the option as required. Remember, this is option, which means optional. If you add it here, if you don't add it, it works just fine. I need to comment these. If you don't add it, then it's fine. You can see it's fine because it's option. But once you specify it, if I say name, required name, and I don't put anything, it will fail. Required name option requires a value because it's required. But if I don't specify it will run just fine. So this is the difference between the arguments and option. The option, you don't need to specify it because it's optional anyway, but once you specify it, then the rule will apply whether it's required or a optional. So I will have a my name Alaa, and then it will run just fine. To get it, I will say required name equals input get option, and then I will call it a required name, and output right line required name. Now if I run this again, I will get get the name again, required name. But also I can have this as option, as array, sorry. So if I put is array, then I will have this la, and then if I put another option and I will call it say James, if I put another option word name and I'll call it X. So you will get these names as required names as an array, because you can specify as many as you want, and these will be as an array, and it will be required at least, if they are array and required, at least one option is specified, is put the value to it. But if you don't specify it, it's still fine. So if I go here, don't specify it, it's just fine. Now we have these. Now we will also have the same thing. We will have the same thing, but will be option value optional. Value optional means, so I will have these optional, and I will have this optional. Comment this and copy, comment, put the optional here. This will be optional name. Now this will be an optional name. If I put optional name and specify nothing, it will run just fine because it's optional in the first place, and also the value is optional. So you don't need to specify anything here, and also you can specify it but provide no value, and also you can have a value and then you will get it. So this is the difference between the optional and required, and the difference between arguments and options. Now we have these as values and as optional and required. Now I will show you another thing. Is where do I go? Another thing is value none. So these will be value none, and it will be false, and this will be false. The value none, it means it's a flag but it doesn't have any values in it. And to have this, then we need to have a right line, and then I will say bool input get option false. Now if I do here and I run just run, I will get a false, but it doesn't show, because if I just turn it into int, and then yeah, still not showing. What I need to do here, I think, is just have copy var dom it, so you can see the value. Now in the var dom it says false, bool false, and then I got 0. If I specify it, then I will get true and I'll get 1. So what is this used for? Say for example, if you want to populate a table, if it is populated, then it will skip it. But if you say false, then it will delete the table and repopulate it again. So the ideal example for it is you will say if this or output fact is input get option false output right line running by false. So suppose this is a method, it only runs when you specify the flag false. So if I do this, nothing happened, but if I specify with false, then it will run in, it will be running by false. So this is a flag and accept no value, but it will just return false or true. If you specify it, will return true. If you don't specify it, will return false. And based on this, you can have this flag to whether run a method or not based on this flag. So you want to put this only to consolidate and validate the user won't really want this to happen, so they can specify false and they know what they're doing. But if they don't specify false, then it will not doing anything. So for example, we can have else output line danger, you must know what are you doing. And in this way you can have false to force something to run. If you don't specify it, then it will not run. If I go here and then run it, it will say danger, and then if you run it with the force, then it will be running by force. And I think this is it. Please like and subscribe if you like the video, and I'll see you next time.